Hello everyone, good morning, and thank you so much for joining us live on Zoom for our session Turn Up the Heat and Begin Your Creative Bread and Pastry Making Adventure, jointly brought to you by LHub and FairPrice. My name is Fiona Low, and I'm your host today. Now today, here in this beautiful studio with me is our esteemed guest. We have Principal Chef Judy Koh, and also two aspiring bakers standing next to her, who are also part of the LHub team. We have Wingy and Lam all the way on the other side. So for all our viewers tuning in right now, today will be a fun and interactive session. So stay with us, because at the end of the show, we have some exciting prizes to give away. So before we start, let's go around and do a self-introduction about ourselves first. Can we start with Principal Chef, Ms. Judy Koh? Chef Judy, tell us a little bit more about yourself.
Yes, hi. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us. Well, I've been in this industry for 30 over years. I'm the founder of Creative Culinaire Academy and Café Pralé. My team and I have been involved in quite a number of record-breaking events, such as the world's tallest chocolate sculpture that went into the Guinness Book of Records in 2008, the longest Swiss roll, the largest, and several other record-breaking events. And if you have watched the Crazy Rich Asians, we made the wedding, the grand wedding cake at the end of the show, where they had this wedding scene at the Gardens by the Bay. So baking has always been a passion for me and my team. So I'm so excited that you're joining us today.
Yeah. I've seen the cake on the movie. It is really, really beautiful. And I didn't know that it was you behind it, Chef Judy.
Yes.
It's beautiful. So kudos to you and your team for creating that. And also, you know, getting the beautiful cake on set as well. I'm sure that must not have been easy.
Yes, right? that was well, you went into our company van. We had to assemble all the layers by, you know, each layer at the scene itself.
So yeah. How tall was it actually?
Well, it was at least about 5 feet, all right, yes.
Wow, how long did it take for you guys to bake
it? It was quite a bit of planning for several months away ahead, and then we had to bake layers and then had to do by layer, yes.
That's amazing. So today we're super excited to be learning from Chef Judy. And also we have our two aspiring bakers from LHub here today. Maybe I'll let them talk about themselves a little bit more. All the way on the end there we have Lam. Good morning, Lam. Tell us a bit more about yourself.
Yeah, so I'm Lam. My name is Lam Hide. Yeah, so I'm from LHub. I recently just joined LHub not too long ago. Yeah, so I'm very fortunate that you guys invited me here over to learn about this baking. So maybe in the future I can bring it over to my family and I can teach them how to do it. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, so this is a very good opportunity for me to be here.
So Lam, do you have any experience with baking?
I do a bit because I do help with my mother sometimes with her kueh tarts. Yeah. So she do a lot of kueh tarts before the Hari Raya events. So about a week or two before that, we'll be rushing around doing the stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a lot. Perfect. So today we also have someone who is very experienced with kueh making. So help us out. And what about you, Wingy?
Hey, morning. This is Wingy here. I'm from LHub also. So I've been LHub for 5 years. So basically, I'm the cost consultant from LHub and providing the consultation service, right, for people who walk in and would like to know about how to upskill themselves and what are the funding available that can utilize for courses like, you know, baking, okay? Basically, when they walk in, they will see me sit at the counter.
So nice to have a familiar face. Now we have seen how you look like. Next time, if we go over to LHub, we can definitely look out for you.
Sure.
So, Wingy, do you have any prior experience with baking?
Yes, I did.
Oh, what have you baked before?
More like a small cupcake only.
Okay, that's nice. Well, for myself, I have dabbled a little bit in baking, but it hasn't been very successful lately. So today I come with the excitement to learn from Chef Judy. Yeah. And also because Hari Raya is just around the corner, right? So today our baking, do you want to review what we are baking today first, Chef?
Well, one of the most popular items served at festivals, especially I think Hari Raya, would be, of course, the Kueh Lapis, which is actually the cousin of the Bamkuhan Dutch layered round cakes. Because the history goes back to in Indonesia, when the Dutch, during the colonization, the Dutch brought in this round bumkuhan layered cakes to the Indonesians, and then Indonesians added their own herbs and their spices and all that. So this has a very long history. Yes. So, but today we're going to do a very exciting lapis. Normally, we know lapis as a cake that is very high in cholesterol with lots of eggs, egg yolks. Today, we're going to do a very low cholesterol cake with 100% of egg white. So you must stay tuned with us.
Oh, yes. I've never ever heard of egg white kueh lapis. I have different kinds of kueh lapis, the original one, the one with yes. Prunes in it. Oh, that's my favorite actually. Do you like
yeah,
that as
yeah,
well?
Yes, yes,
yeah.
Yes.
And of course, as you can see today, we are all dressed up according yeah. to the theme. I'm in a kebaya. And
so beautiful,
in,
right?
Yeah, this color is amazing.
Thank you.
Weiji is in a baju kurung, and of yeah. course, Lam with his very nice shirt as well. So I think it's time to start baking, Chef. What do you think?
Yes, of course. Let's start by introducing the ingredients. They are all halal ingredients, which you can easily buy them from NTUC, any fair price that is near your place. Now, first, let me just introduce the seven ingredients here. We have coconut milk, thick coconut milk. You can buy those in the packet form from the NTUC as well, pasteurized coconut milk. So long ago, you know, people used to get the coconut grated in the market, but yeah. then this is convenient, so and it's good coconut milk. And we also have got pandan leaves. Now, what pandan leaves to give a natural fragrance to the cake. And we also have got flour, plain flour, or what we call medium protein flour, some softened butter. I use unsalted butter. So if it's unsalted butter, I put a little bit of salt, but you are free to use salted butter and skip the salt. And I've got pure egg whites. Now, if you take a look at the egg whites, it's very important that it must be free from yolks when you separate them, okay? And I have fine sugar. You can use fine or caster sugar. That's okay, all right? And a little bit of vanilla essence. You can get those small bottles from NTUC FairPrice, and some food coloring. So I've got food coloring and a little bit of pandan paste. Now, of course, these are, you know, these are in larger bottles because, you know, we operate a bakery here. So, but you can get the small ones from NTUC. You know, fair price.
Yeah, yeah. That's right. In yeah. fact, all the ingredients that Chef Judy has just mentioned can all be found and purchased at the Fair Price app. And just so you know, we have also pinned up the ingredient list on the chat box. So if you want to, you know, keep track of what's going on here, feel free to check out the chat box. And also, we will be sending you an EDM of today's recipe as well. So Chef Judy, back to you.
Yes. Okay. The first step is to actually process the coconut milk. Now, in this saucepan is my coconut milk. I put a little bit of salt. Salt brings out the taste of the cake, and it's a very good flavoring, but not too much, just a bit of it. In fact, in the recipe, we only put about 1/8 teaspoon. Okay, so I put salt, lots of kueh, you know, not just this cake. Anything to do with coconut, we like to bring the salt because it seems to bring up the flavor of it. And these are our pandan leaves. If you have a pot growing, you know, along the corridor, these are really useful. Okay, so gives a nice fragrance. We tear the pandan leaves so that we can extract the maximum amount of fragrance from the pandan leaves. Okay. You know, I don't know if Lam, you already can smell
yeah, can
the...
Smell
yeah, that's yeah, a beautiful great. Part. So it's not just for putting at the back of the taxi to drive away cockroach, you know. But it's a great flavoring natural agent. Yeah. And I've seen this in NTUC. You know, it's sold in the vegetable fruit section, so yes. you can just buy them. And what we do is to first place the saucepan, okay, on the fire top. And we bring this to a boil, okay? All
right. So during this part, yes. Chef, do we have to be very careful to watch over the boiling?
Yes. Okay, for this amount, it's just for 1 8-inch square tin cake. The coconut milk is not a lot. It's just for the flavoring. You see, sometimes when we take out something, we need to replace something to compensate for the loss in flavor. Now, early on, I was saying that, you know, when it comes to kueh lapis, usually it's a lot of egg yolks. Why? Because egg yolk is a natural emulsifier. It gives moisture, color, and it's very fragrant. Mm. So once we take out the egg yolk completely from the recipe, we need to realize that there's a slight loss in flavor. So what we do is that we replace it with, you know, natural pandan leaves and a little bit of coconut milk for the richer mouthfeel that will be lost if we remove the egg yolk completely.
Oh, yeah. I'm excited to try egg white kueh lapis.
Yes. Mm. Okay. So, all right. Now, once you start to notice there's steam coming out, that's the time you have to watch out. Okay. But if you are doing many shares of this, which I hope you will be doing that, you know, then just be careful. If you multiply like 10 shares, it will be 10 times the amount of coconut milk. Everything will be 10 times. Then just be careful it doesn't boil over. Okay, so, all right. So once this is done, okay, we leave it, set it aside to cool. All right, we can also transfer this into another bowl so that it will cool a lot faster. Okay, or plunge this in a basin of cold water, or just simply leave it outside, you know. Okay, so this will be our pandan.
So right pandan now, we're flavored. Making the first layer of the kueh lapis. I'm actually curious to know, how many layers are there in kueh lapis?
Well, that's going to be about 20 over to 30 layers, okay?
Oh.
I tell you what, you know what's the most important ingredient in making kueh lapis?
What is it?
Starts with a P, guess. Patience. You need at least 10 kilos of that. Okay?
Oh,
of patience,
wow.
Layer thank by you. Layer, and lots of love in your heart. And I think this is what Hari Raya is about too.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, definitely.
Just now when Lam said that, you know, he helps the mother. Oh, as a mother and grandmother myself, I could feel the, you know, I could feel the love of coming from him for his mom, you know, and this is a thing that I really admire among the Muslim community, how you take the time to gather together, you know, make something together for your family. And I think this tradition should be continued.
Definitely.
And, you know, for all cultures as well. Now, once the coconut milk has been processed, the next step is to cream the butter. So I've got some unsalted butter here, but as mentioned, you can, if you wish to, just use salted butter, that's fine, okay? And what we do is to put the butter into this mixing bowl. Now, I know this, we are using quite big machines here, equipment in our academy. It's partly because, you know, we do have, you know, sometimes when you do in volume, like for example, if you're going to make like 10 lapis, you probably need a big mixer. Mm-hmm. But if you have a handheld one, for one share is sufficient, okay? So don't let the size of the equipment be a discouragement. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so I've got butter here, and the next step we're going to do is to just cream the butter. So this is a little bit unusual because we are creaming just the butter without the sugar. Because later on, we're going to put the sugar into the egg whites to whip. Okay?
Ah, I see.
So now, when you have a mixer like this, usually it comes with several attachments. So we use a paddle to do the creaming. Now, in our WSQ courses, we always talk about the different types of cakes, you know, and what tool and what equipment to use. But if you are at home, you can also use your handheld mixers, because the handheld mixers with the pad, that can also do the creaming. Okay? All right. So now I start off by the lower speed because we don't want to use high speed. It may generate the heat and then that will cause the melting of the butter.
I see.
So we just cream.
So what happens if the butter is too cold? Do we have to leave it out for a while first?
Well, if the butter is too cold, you just either leave it out for a while to soften. Or you can just put it in and just cream a little bit longer. But these days, Singapore is so hot, you know. You put there, you know.
10 minutes, so, I think it's more than enough, right?
Right, yes.
Maybe while we're waiting for the butter to be creamed, Lam, can I ask you, you know, what is Hari Raya usually like in your house?
Oh, Hari Raya for me in my house is quite chaotic because the first week before Hari Raya, definitely we do some cleaning. We'll take the furniture, remove the furniture, remove the bed, clean everything. Every dust we see, we'll just clean. Because we want it to be nice and clean before people come in. So at least when they come in, they feel nice. Yeah. Then 2 weeks before that, we'll be doing like kuehs. So my mother loves to make all these kueh tarts and everything. So she'll do all the batter, she'll do all the pineapples, and then I'll just help her like pack it up around. Because I can't do the baking, because I'm not that good in it. Yeah, I'm
scared. But now you can, after learning today's class, right?
So I'm not that good in it, so I just help her pack it up. So place it nicely around the table. Yeah, just wait for people to come. Yeah, so that's about it, it's quite chaotic.
So is it like a little factory situation going in your kitchen?
It's a one-man kind of factory. It's my mother's doing it, and I'm just packing the stuff in it.
Oh, that's amazing. So can we also invite ourselves to your house for
Hari
Raya?
Sure, everyone's welcome.
When I hear him talk like this, you know, such a nice filial son helping. I don't mind to have 20 of such sons, right?
Of course, definitely.
They run a bakery.
Yeah. It can be a family business, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah, that's right.
So, Chef, how long do we need to cream the butter?
Yeah, we only cream until it softens. Mm-hmm. So, one way to check is to stop the machine and scrape it down. Now, let me just use the spatula. This is the right tool for the right job. So, we've got the spatula here. Now, if I were to scrape it by the side, my butter is still quite yellow. Mm-hmm. Of course, the color of the butter sometimes depends on the brand that you use. Whether the cows have been fed grass or wheat, you know, or other types of food that will color the butter. So coloring itself is not a good accurate, but if you, with a gentle flick, the butter should just drop off from the spatula. So you can see it's not dropped off yet. So which means I have to cream a little bit longer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And also, by the way, guys, you know, if you have ever encountered instances where, you know, you're prepared to whip up a feast, but you just forgot like one or two items.
Yeah.
Has that happened before? Yes, it does, right? Yeah. Well, the great news is that, you know, because the FairPrice app does its delivery in about 2 hours time. So if you're in a super great big rush, right, you can actually order from the app. And also, what is included in the app, right? You know, we have trained pickers who ensure that the products are fresh in your order and is in great condition and quality before they put it out to be sent to you. And freshness is definitely guaranteed. So if you receive an unsatisfactory fresh product, we promise you, we guarantee a refund. Okay, and there are many unique fresh brands such as Al's Market, Sasha's Fine Foods, and a frozen sweet tune dim sum. Oh, that's my favorite dim sum. Oh, I'm so happy now they have it in FairPrice, and of course, many, many more. Okay, and you can also buy Hari Raya decorations off FairPrice online. Yeah, so if you guys, you know, you're decorating and you realize, oh, I forgot about these things, or you know, this particular spot is not decorated enough, quickly go onto the app and you can make the purchase. And great news, you can get $5 off when you key in the promo code BAKINGFRESH. Okay, we're going to post it onto the chat, BAKINGFRESH, there's no space in between, when you purchase a minimum of $35 of fresh products. Now, this is only valid for FairPrice app orders only, and it is valid all the way until 22nd of April, which is next Friday. So there's limited redemption, so fastest fingers first. Okay, now let's come back to what's happening over here. So Chef is still creaming the butter.
Yes, we are still creaming the butter, but it's going to be ready soon. As I said, in making cakes, we really need, especially kueh lapis, at least 10 kilos of patience. So this is the time when your family gets together to make it. You know, we smile at our sons and daughters. You know, we're surrounded by love. And really, baking should be from the heart. Because, you know, love for not just baking, but the fact that food brings so much joy to our friends and loved ones, okay? So,
maybe that's the reason why my bakes haven't been successful, because I'm lacking the patience. Maybe I only have 2 kilos of patience. But Chef, when it comes to baking, right, is precision the key as well?
Sorry,
you have patience, is precision also the key?
Patience?
and precision.
Yes, precision is important because that's why we mentioned that, you know, at our academy and at our WSQ courses, we emphasize a lot on the science of baking because functions of ingredients, you know, and we cannot, like what we say when it comes to baking, agar-agar, because, you know, we sort of estimate, you know, if we get agar-agar today, the kueh lapis will be agar-agar this high, agar-agar that high. So it's more precise. We actually have to weigh, you know, and it, in some ways, it is more, as mentioned, more precise. You're right about it, okay?
I mean, so, compared to cooking, right? Because cooking a lot is all about, like, you know, agar-agar, put in as much as you want.
Yes, if it's cooking for home, but if you cook for the cafe or F&B business, if you agar-agar, then you
also agar-agar, right?
Yeah, need to be also quite precise, okay? Yeah. Now, so here I've got my butter now. Now you can feel that, you see, with the gentle flick, it sort of drops off. And this is where you can stop creaming. And because I can't really tell you that, oh, we cream for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, because it really depends a lot on the conditions, the temperature of your environment. When it comes to cakes, we take note of the environment. When we come, if we were to learn to make breads, temperature is even more important, something we emphasize quite a lot at our WSQ courses. Okay, so now that the butter has been creamed to the texture that is required, our coconut milk would have cooled. And I'm going to add in the coconut milk a bit at a time, okay? So let it get absorbed. And this is where I'm going to invite Lam to help me, okay? So he can add in the coconut milk a bit at a time.
A bit at a time.
Now, if he adds too quickly, what it will happen is that the because coconut milk contains some water, so it will separate from the butter. So need to be patient to add a bit at a time, observe, you know. And I'm going to pretend to be his mother or grandmother. So when he does that, every time he pours in, he's going to look at me and smile. Yeah, you see? This is what, I mean, when we were, I still have memories of my grandmother, you know, baking and doing kueh with me when we were young. Because when you do that, it actually helps to bond the family together, right?
Actually, I'm also looking at the chat box, right? Yes. Earlier on, somebody did ask if we are putting up the recipe. So yes, the chat box, we are posting the recipe already. And the ingredients, by the way, are all purchased from FairPrice. So if there's anything, you know, that you see here from the ingredient list, they're all halal, by the way. And we've included the link in the chat box as well. So someone did request to see the texture of the butter and the coconut milk. So let's try perhaps to hold it up later when we're done to show how it's
okay. Actually, Lam has added already all close to half the coconut milk. And look at the texture. Okay? Yes. He's done a wonderful job.
Huh? Wow.
Great job. Lam's mummy, if you're watching, I think
you can be
very
proud.
Raised a great son.
And Chef, we're seeing some questions coming in as well. Can I use milk or soy milk to replace egg white for an eggless lapis?
Not to replace egg white. I will explain to you in a short while because the egg white is the one that gives the air bubbles and the volume to the texture. But I think if you wish to replace the coconut milk with soy milk, you probably can. Except that coconut milk is of course higher in fat, so has a richer mouthfeel and a more, what you say, more coconutty kind of fragrance.
That's okay. Very nice. Yeah. Okay. Is there a particular brand of butter to use? Chef, this is your expertise.
You first, I think if you go to the NTUC, you have many brands.
Definitely.
But of course, today we are using Anchor Butter.
Okay.
One of my favorites butter, but there are several brands in NTUC which you can choose from as well. Yeah.
Would you say that, you know, the brand of butter that you buy, definitely the taste will be different, but it's also to your personal preference as well?
Yes. You can look at the fat content in the various brands of butter. So the fat content will sort of affect, and you can, you know, look into whether the cows, you know, free-ranging cows, grass-fed, or, you know, different. That will color the flavor and the look of the butter.
I see. Yeah. So Wenji, let's have a little chat with you while we're waiting for you know this part to happen. So Wenji, you're a cost consultant at LHub, and you've been there for 5 years. So you're pretty much a senior there already. Can you tell us, aside from a baking course like this, what other courses are available if we know we want to sign up?
Actually, right, for there's a lot of the BSQ courses that is a funded courses, not only for Singapore citizens, but also for PR also.
Oh, so, that's like, great news.
Correct. So right, besides the pastry courses, like we also have like bread baking courses, we also have cake decoration, we also have like even like some coffee courses, prepared co and various, for those who already have passion in F&B industry.
Oh, that's very nice to know. And also, you know, there's a lot of courses available. They can come to you definitely to find out a little bit more. And just so you guys know, we also have our consultants on standby as well. So if you have any questions about the courses offered by LHub, please feel free to ask them into the chat box as well. And also, I want to know, are there any funding available for these courses?
Yes, for all the BSQ courses, right, most for Singapore citizens, let's say they are age 25 and above, they will have the SkillFuture account to utilize it. So right, there is a SkillFuture credit. So after the funding, right, like let's say the learner supposed to pay this amount, if let's say they have sufficient fund in their SkillFuture credit account, they can actually utilize the credit and offset the amount entirely, included GST.
Oh, that's wonderful. So they can even, you know, attend a course without, you know, paying anything.
No cash involved.
No cash involved?
Yep.
Wow,
if let's say they have sufficient credit. But of course, for those, like, we also met like some very keen learners that took up many courses, like, so they maybe utilize their SkillFuture credit already.
So what happens to them?
So right, the good news is they can actually join for NTUC payout member with the subscription. So there is a funding called UTEP, Union Training Assistant Program. Okay, so this UTEP, we're actually like helping them like up to $250 per year. So when they sign up for the courses, right, the UTEP actually can like partly claim under the course fee, like up to 50%.
Oh, that's wonderful to know.
Yeah, so for NTUC member, worthy on the member, of course, definitely they can like, you know, take up this like benefit, you know, to learn for the courses.
And how can they sign up for the membership?
They can sign up online also, but of course, if they don't know how to do, feel free to approach us. Yeah, we have a lot of counters, sales counter branches in Singapore, like Jurong, Jurong East, Dewan Naya. We have Bras Basah, we also have Paya Lebar. Then we also have Aljunied, Tampines, Ang Mo Kio, Kulen. So there'll be a lot of counter and branches ready to, you know, serve for the our customer.
Oh, that's really like all over Singapore, right? So you guys have made it very, very easy to access to you guys and the amazing list of courses that LHub offers as well. Oh, that's wonderful. I'm excited. Okay, I think I'm thinking if I want to take up a baking course by myself as well, since I'm so bad at baking, but I think I can still be saved. It's not the end. But Chef, it looks like you're ready with the buttered coconut milk. Shall we come back to you?
Okay, Lam has done a wonderful job, and you can see it's all the coconut milk has been added into the mixture, into the butter mixture, so it's smooth, it's not separated, and it's beautifully silky smooth. So, you know, at this point, we can then start to whisk the egg whites. Now, as mentioned, there are only seven ingredients, so it's really very simple. After creaming the butter, we will then incorporate the egg whites. Now, before we do that, we actually whip the egg whites. Now, there is a term for when we have egg whites and sugar, it's called the meringue. So meringues, there are different types of meringues, and you have the fresh meringue, such as what we're going to do now, where we don't cook the egg whites, we just simply add sugar to the egg whites, and with the whisk, we whisk it up. So here, it's important to note that the bowl must be dry, must be clean, must not have any amount of oil. And as mentioned, egg whites should be separated really well so that it's just pure egg whites. Just a tip, for those of you who are going to do your traditional kueh lapis, where you use a lot of yolk, so you'll be left with a lot of egg whites. Now, then you can store the egg whites in the refrigerator and keep it for within that week, try to make this egg white lapis. So there won't be any wastage. Okay, so use up the egg whites for this cake. Yeah.
So okay. Is the French meringue also makes macarons as well, right?
Yes. In fact, when it comes to macaron, there are three different types, ways of making that. It could be the Italian meringue or the Swiss meringue, which we mention and demonstrate during our WSQ more advanced cake courses called Make Western Cakes and Pastries. Ah. So you can learn all about that. Yeah. So, but at this moment, it's just French meringue, so you can easily, you know, just whip this up. So what we do is, we start whipping the egg whites at medium speed to get the engine going, all right? Now, once that is done, we will actually add in the sugar. It could be what we call caster sugar or fine sugar. And we add the sugar gradually. Now, don't pour all the sugar at one go into the egg white, because even though that is not going to be a major disaster, it's going to take a really long time for the egg whites to whip up. So always when you start whisking for maybe a couple of minutes until you see lots of foam, then we add in the sugar in a steady stream. Okay, I'm going to do this so that you can see. Let me see if this is better. Yeah. Okay, yeah, I think here you can catch the sugar going in.
Is this also a delicate process? If you do it too quickly, this is a step that you can easily get wrong, right? And then you have to repeat the entire process again.
Okay, what will go wrong is if your egg whites don't whisk up, usually it could be an indication that there was some oil or grease somewhere, or egg yolks actually dropped into the egg whites. That will affect the whipping.
I didn't know that. Chef, I have a very embarrassing situation to share with you. Yeah. So I've tried to make the French meringue, but I think there was something wrong with my whisk. So I decided to hand whisk it. And 1 hour later, there's nothing. Where did I go wrong? So many places, right?
Yes. Actually, when it comes to whisking by hand, it's not impossible, but you really need to know the technique, you know? Like, I think you're referring to a hand whisk. Perhaps, let me just show you this one. Maybe, you know, Fiona was referring to this hand whisk. Then, you know, if you were to just stand there and stir, nothing will happen. So you actually need a little bit of elbow grease and effort to do it. So for this one, you can also do it, but it's going to take quite a long time.
I know, because I started like this, and then I ended like this. And I just gave up.
That's why sometimes to have the proper equipment, that will help.
Definitely.
Actually, I have memories of my late grandmother, you know, getting me to whisk, you know, those whisks where it went this way, you know. So we actually had to do this and whisk it this way. Wow, it took quite a long time, but it was a very efficient way of getting egg whites to fluff up.
It's a great arm workout as well, right?
Yes, I still remember doing this, and then my younger brother was sleeping in the yona, you know, those cradle,
the cradle
sarong cradle.
Yes.
And so I had to whisk this, I'm going to do this, you know, to my brother to rock him to sleep.
That's in multitasking.
Days, yeah, in those days, we had to really help out a lot in the house. Okay. All right, now I've been whisking at medium speed. I'm going to go slightly higher, okay, so, all right, this way.
Chef, we have a question coming in. Necessary to add cream or of tartar or lemon juice?
Okay, if you are going to do just 1 share, 2 shares, or even 5 shares, it's not really necessary to add cream of tartar. Now, this person who asked this question also tells me that she or he knows something about the baking ingredients. Now, cream of tartar is actually an excellent ingredient to stabilize your egg whites, which means that it is unlikely you will over whisk, okay? It helps. But as far as possible, we keep the ingredients simple, you know. And so in this case, I have not added any cream of tartar. Yeah.
Look at that, it's barely 2 minutes and it's already beautiful. I don't want to be reminded of my whisking situation.
Yeah, okay, so now this is French meringue, so it's been whisked to this stage. You see, it's
beautiful.
It's quite stiff. I can lift up my entire bowl. I think I need the strong arms of lump. Yes, okay, you can invert it. All right, turn it upside down. Okay, it's not too going to drop.
Oh, wow.
Okay?
Oh.
All right, yeah.
That's
okay,
beautiful.
Great. Okay, so we should whisk to this stage. And once it's done, okay, I'm going to then start to fold in the egg whites and the egg yolks, okay, into the mixture. Sorry, not egg yolks. There's no egg yolks in this recipe. Sometimes we are so used to, you know, making the conventional lapis with lots of yolks, that word just comes out from our mouth, right? Okay, just a minute. Maybe I can get Lam to help me with a hand glove to remove as much of the egg white as possible. Okay?
Chef, there's another question. Should we whisk cold egg whites to maintain structure easily?
Actually, we normally prefer to whisk egg white at room temperature because then you can get it to fluff up faster. It's not really true to say that cold egg whites are more stable. It's just that, yes, sort of like push it. Okay, not really true to say that, but it's just that it will just take a longer time to whisk. And the egg whites mustn't be kept in the fridge for too long time. Once it loses its viscosity, it starts to look very watery. That's when it's not very good for making cakes.
Right.
Better use it to make egg white soup or something. Yeah. Okay. All right. Yeah.
Wingji, coming back to you, right? Can you share with us what are some courses that are very trendy at LHub? You know, the ones that are very, very popular.
Very popular. Mm. A lot of our courses are popular.
Can you share with me maybe like one or two of them?
Currently very trendy, like if let's say it's related to back to the F&B, like people who want to do their business, right? So a lot of them, they don't know how to start. So we have a lot of inquiries about our digital marketing course.
Oh, wow.
So in the digital marketing course, right, our world trainer will actually guide them like about some of the very basic, like let's say search engine optimization, like how to bring up the keyword to be searchable. And it's a very interesting courses. If let's say even not for people who want to do business, but nowadays, because it's a digital world, so the digital marketing is very important, regardless for normal business or maybe for someone who are working.
I see. I have noticed that there's a rise in the number of home businesses, you know, especially in the past 2 years or so. So I'm really happy to hear that, you know, LHub is really offering these courses, you know, to encourage, you know, if you want to start your home business, we're going to help you to do that and make it easier to bridge.
Yeah, but of course, besides those, like, you know, F&B, like, we also have courses like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, like, for people who want to upskill themselves. Yeah, so one of the very popular courses would be our Microsoft Excel course as well. Yeah, because I believe Excel, like, regardless where you're working or maybe in your daily life, right, you will need it, you know, for some kind of job, like your scheduling, maybe your budgeting. So you use the Excel. And also, Excel is very good tool for data analysis as well.
It is, which is also a hot thing now, right?
Yeah, correct.
Thank you so much for sharing that with us. So I can see that, Chef, you really started to put the butter into the egg whites.
Yes.
And we should do this gradually as well.
Yes, that's right. Now, again, because butter contains fat and egg white is just water in the... You know the structure of the egg white contains lots of water, so you really have to add in the butter in batches. Okay, it may look as if it's going to separate, but with a little bit of patience, they will all be mixed quite well together. Okay, so this is where you can use the machine to mix the yolk mixture, egg white into the egg white mixture.
Really too used to egg yolks, right?
Yeah, so used to egg yolks. Yeah. Now this is really a healthy and tasty and cheerful looking cake because as mentioned, you know, it really is lower in cholesterol because we're not using the cholesterol, high cholesterol egg yolks in this recipe. Okay, so we add this in like this, a bit at a time, scooping up. Until all the yolk mix, all the butter mixture is added. Oh my. You know, I understand there are a few thousand of you watching this, so it does make us a little bit nervous sometimes, you know. despite having been in this industry for more than 30 over years, you know, it's still...
I'm sure.
It gets into us, huh?
So, Chef, do you conduct courses like this very frequently?
Sorry?
Yeah. Do you conduct courses like this very frequently?
All the time, all the time. Of course, we have a team at our academy. I saw some question asking where we are situated. We are actually at Tiong Bahru. Mm-hmm. We have been here for the past 17 years.
Oh, wow.
Imagine.
Congratulations, that's a really
long
time.
Yeah, thank God. So now we have a team of chefs, full-time chefs, including my 29-year-old son, who's also the chef.
Oh,
so
wow.
So we are all ECTA certified and conducting this course there. It's really our passion.
So were you like Lam's mom who made your son, you know, stay with you in the kitchen while you were cooking and baking? And that's how he got inspired to do that as well.
Yes, yes. Actually, I have a beautiful daughter in her 30s, mm-hmm. who's older than the brother.
Yeah.
Both were exposed to the same kind of environment. But of course, the son has a passion to do this for the F&B business.
Yeah. Oh, that's wonderful.
So it's always... I think the most important thing is that, you know, whether we are making cakes with our loved ones or is to spend the time with them, you know, to create happy memories. Whether they end up as a chef or not, it really, you know, it's really up to them. Well, we want them to be happy, but the time to make this cake together, you know, grilling the lapis layer by layer, is really truly precious.
Oh, yeah? It's a great bonding experience, right?
Yes, correct.
Oh,
okay.
Lovely.
So now all the butter has been added to the egg white mixture. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to just show you what the mixture looks like. Now, sometimes you do get some of the egg whites caught at the sides of the bowl. So we just fold it in. Okay. All right. Fold it in. Include all the egg whites into the mixture. So now don't get worried if you see that, oh, it's not absolutely smooth, okay? And that's like life. Nothing goes absolutely smooth. But, you know, don't stop. We continue the process, and then it will turn out to be a beautiful item, okay? So, because it's quite impossible for it to be totally smooth, because one is completely fat, the other one is egg white. But as long as you get the butter in, and then we have the flour as a binder. Now, this is our... all-purpose flour, so I'm going to sieve it in like this. Okay, in batches. And I'm going to get Lam to help me. Actually, I should get our beautiful girl here to also
help me.
Yes, if you want to. Okay, yeah. But if you still have things to interview her, then I will get in.
Yeah. We can talk and whisk at the same time.
Okay.
No problem.
Yeah, come. One person can whisk. Wow. Can fold. Okay, maybe I just give some tips about folding.
Yes.
So what we do is we just put in a circle, cut in the center, go in a circle, cut in the center, go in a circle, and then cut in the center while we sieve some flour, into the mixture.
Angie said, I'm so sorry, I missed the first 15 minutes. Can I have the video later? Sorry, my fault, busy with housework. Oh, Angie, thank you so much for tuning in, even though you're busy with your housework. We are currently about halfway through the recipe, but feel free to ask us any questions. And since you know, Chef is here, you can ask her more tips and tricks about baking, how to get your bakes right. Okay, so let me check in on the guys to see how they're doing. Are you guys doing okay?
Learning.
Don't worry, see, Chef is watching the two of you at the side. No stress, no pressure.
Yes, no stress, no pressure. I think what we must remember that anything happens, we can eat our mistakes.
That's true.
So what
happens, Chef, if at this point I over-whisk, you know, this mixture, what will happen?
Yeah, if you over-mix, it just becomes a little bit more watery. But you will get a slightly lower... in volume cake, but it will still be perfectly edible. So what the trick is to just fold in the egg white and fold the flour in the egg white. As soon as it's mixed well, stop, go on to the next. Yeah. Mm. Okay, yes, I think we can proceed. You don't have to wait too long in between. As long as it's relatively well mixed. Okay? Yeah.
Okay, let's take a look. Will you send us this recipe? Yes. In fact, we have just posted the PDF on the chat box now. And we also have the link to get hold of the recipe and the ingredients, which, by the way, these are all halal ingredients that were purchased from FairPrice. And you can also find them on the FairPrice app as well.
Okay, yep. Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Oh, Chef, we got a very interesting question coming in. What is the best egg or egg white substitute for vegetarians? You mean vegans? For vegans?
Well, I think you can, for this particular cake, if you use egg white substitutes and all that, then we would have to check with some of the suppliers. There are sometimes substitutes, but substitutes are just substitutes. You know, it's never exactly the same.
I see.
Okay, so my suggestion is wait till our next session where we might just do a vegetarian cakes, right?
Oh, yeah. That's interesting. Is it going to be a course available on LHub as well?
We can think about it. Sometimes at our academy, yes. I'm sure that we will, yes.
Amazing. Because I also do know that there's a large community of vegans here in Singapore as well. So if you think that it is, we'll definitely give us a feedback and we'll see if we can put something together, especially for you guys.
Yes.
Okay. And, we got another question coming in. This one is from Yin Yin. Will handheld mixer produce the same results? Oh, Chef, I think you talked about this earlier, right?
Yes. Yes. Earlier on, I did mention if you use a handheld machine, it's possible. But it's just that with this amount of egg whites, I think we use about 14 egg whites, 14 to 15 egg whites. You have to measure the weight is given in the recipe, but you need to break the eggs and then measure the egg white carefully. Measuring is very important. And then from there, I think it's about close to 14 egg whites. So with a handheld machine, it's going to take slightly longer.
Yeah. And maybe, Chef, would you want to take this opportunity to tell us a little bit more about your academy? There were some people who were asking where is it at, right? It's actually located at 17 Eng Hoon Street at Tiong Bahru. It's a beautiful location. And of course, Chef, tell us a little bit more about your academy.
We have two fully equipped kitchens at our academy with a cafe attached. We truly believe that to grow and prosper, to be a blessing to others. And one of the ways is to share with you the secrets of baking. So, you know, so that you can, make this successfully, whether it is for your business or for your
family,
for your loved ones as well. So we have a wide range of courses and we are very happy to work with LHub to promote the love and passion for baking. Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful. Yes. Chef, we have actually a very good question from Mei Fong. What do we do with leftover egg yolks?
Then make your regular lapis.
So regular lapis don't need egg white?
Sorry?
Regular lapis don't need egg white?
Well, there are different types of lapis. You know, some lapis use whole eggs, but most of them, there is a great amount of egg yolks in the recipe. So you can do the, you know, like a lapis, use the egg yolks to make your normal lapis.
Yeah. Right, okay.
All right, now what I'm doing now is to separate the cake batter into three portions. One portion about 430 grams. So that's why a good weighing scale is very important. Don't agar-agar, you know. So we have three different amounts of batter here. Three different portions, three portions that we're going to color. One will be a little bit of pink, okay? This is where I'm going to get Lam to help me to stir, okay? So when we stir, we try to stir it gently. Yep. Okay. And another portion, I'm going to add pandan paste. Now pandan paste has got color and flavor, so that enhances the look and the taste of the product. Okay, so we just put a little bit of this. Now how much sometimes depends on the thickness, of the coloring.
Chef, can I help you out with that one?
Yeah, sure. Come. Okay.
Yeah, I've been standing at the side and I feel like I'm missing out on the action.
Yeah. Thank you.
And Wen Chi, do you want to help us out with something? Maybe the washing?
I Actually, that is one of the most important things, you know.
Yeah.
Sometimes we have interns at our academy, you know, young people who want to set this up as a business or to know what it's really like. The first thing I tell them is, oh, chefs love people who clean and clean, because we spend almost 30% of our time just to do cleaning. So, you know, you want to get into the good books of the chef, do cleaning.
I can imagine.
Okay, now we're going to get to the baking in a very short while. Now, this recipe goes into an 8-inch square tin, okay? So, what we're going to do for the tin, we put a layer, put the baking paper at the bottom, and I'm going to say something about the oven, okay? Now, baking the kueh lapis requires grilling, so we grill layer by layer. Now, of course, in the industry, some of you may also be familiar with certain types of oven that are quite good with making kueh lapis, but here I have an oven that you might have at home. What we have done is that if you take a look at the inside of the oven, we have put the tray with some water in it. We're going to bake it in this manner so that we have moisture, you know, in the cake and it won't get too dry. Okay, so now I have got. I'm going to start off with the first layer.
How are you doing, Lam?
Yeah, he's doing good. Yeah.
Just now I whispered to Wengji. I asked if she wants to take over. She's like, no, my arm hurts.
Okay. Now, all right. So we got pink here. Okay. Yeah. Now, what is useful would be to have 3 ladles with you, if possible, so that will make the job easier. 1 ladle for the plain one, 1 ladle for the pink, and 1 ladle for the green. Okay?
Okay, how's this, chef?
So at the end of the lapis making, you got a lot of ladles in your house, which means you have to keep on cooking. Yeah. Okay, so what we do is, basically, we take a ladle of this, all right? And we just pour into the tin that's been lined with baking paper. Okay, it's very important because you don't want the cake to get stuck to the bottom of the tin. Okay, so now then you can use the spoon to just spread it. Okay, now sometimes you may have those spoons that are quite thin. You can always bang it flat, you know, to just spread the mixture over it like this. So we spread it like this, okay? So now first layer, we're going to grill it, okay? So the oven has been set to grill mode. So you need to take a look at your oven and grill layer by layer. So we just, for the first layer, just spread it like this. And then we just place it in the oven. Okay, water is already been put into the tray, and so we let it cook for about 8 minutes. We got to press it. If it's sort of once it's cooked, it should not stick to your fingers.
I see.
Once that is done, while it's hot, we spread the next layer, which is the white layer, and then we grill again. Then after that, we do the green one.
Ah, okay. But chef, can I ask, in that case, will the first layer be very burnt?
No, that's where you really need to keep an eye on it. Now, estimated time may be 5 to 8 minutes, but you really have to see, because no two ovens bake the same. Now, as a baker, we may give you the approximate time to bake this, it takes 20 minutes, but you really have to understand the oven that you have. So start by practicing first, you know, and then see whether it can, your oven maybe take 10 minutes, another oven maybe 7 minutes, so you really have to check on that.
Okay, yeah. So we've got to keep a lookout yes. on that, huh? Okay, so while we're waiting for this layer to be baked, to be grilled, you know, then we have more layers to fill up. I think right now, you know, we're going to go into our quiz segment. So this is the part where we have our giveaway, okay? So we're going to select three lucky winners. Are you excited about that?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, you're going to help me to pick my winners, right?
Yeah, but I cannot participate.
Yeah, I know. It's okay. We have Kueh Lapis to eat today. Okay, so we have three prizes. The third prize is a $30 FairPrice e-voucher. Second prize is $50 FairPrice e-voucher, and the first prize is $100 FairPrice e-voucher. Okay, so we're gonna play Kahoot, and I hope that you guys are familiar with Kahoot already. If not, don't worry, I'm gonna take you through step by step. But first and foremost, everybody, you have to key in your name into the game, okay? Please use your real name, because if you're one of the winners, we'll need to know how to contact you, okay? So here we go. We are going to, see there's a QR code at the bottom of the screen already. You can scan the QR code or click on the link in the chat box. Okay, we're going to post it up, or you can go straight to kahoot.it. Okay, we're going to give everybody some time to log into the quiz yet. Please let us know if you're experiencing any technical difficulties. Okay, so once you're inside Kahoot, someone is asking what's the link. Okay, so I think we can try and send the link, the Kahoot link, into the chat box again to make sure that everybody has the link. Okay, so once you're there, please enter the game PIN. It's 3038936, and we're going to show it onto the screen now. Okay, how do you scan? You can use your QR code scanner.
My hand is wet.
Okay, to go over to this page. If you are registered already, please use your real name once again. Okay, you should be able to see the screen with everybody's names popping up. Okay, so very quickly, we have almost 300 participants already. I'm gonna do a quick 10 seconds countdown. Okay, so you guys quickly go in and key in the game PIN. Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, before we launch, this is a quiz game. Okay, so we're gonna put up a few options for you, and the fastest fingers with the correct answer will get the highest point. Okay, so you wanna make sure that you are fast and accurate as well. So, okay, let's get started with our first question. Let's go. Oh, suddenly a lot of people joined. Okay, let's go. The first question is, are you ready? 2, 1. Okay. What was the name of the recipe and what's the main ingredient? Okay, there are four options: Kueh Lapis, Eggless Lapis, Egg White Lapis, or Rainbow Lapis. Ah. Okay, you have 10 seconds to give me your answers. Okay, time's up. Let's see. Most of you answered Egg White Lapis. That's the correct answer. Well done. I know we kind of tricked you with the Rainbow Lapis, right? Because it's so colorful. But let's see who's on the leaderboard. Coming in first, we have Dada and Cindy S and Zena Lee. Well done, guys. We're going to continue to play the game. I think we have 5 more questions to go, and we'll identify the top 3, okay? Second question. Where is NTUC Learning Hub's baking partner, Creative Culinaire Academy, located at? Oh, where are we located at? Let's see, okay, 8 seconds, guys. Are we at Tiong Bahru Plaza, beside Singapore General Hospital, 17 Eng Hoon Street, or Outram Park Station? Well done! Most of you said Eng Hoon Street. Also coming in second is Tiong Bahru Plaza. Not a bad guess since we are located in Tiong Bahru, but well done. Let's take a look at the leaderboard. Is Dada still in the lead? Oh, wow! Dada still in the lead, followed by Jen S, and then Zena Lee still in third place. Well done, everybody. Okay, you guys still have the chance to catch up, okay? Let's go to the next question. When you order groceries online from FairPrice, how fast can the order be delivered? Ooh, is it as fast as 2 hours, as fast as 1 day, as fast as 2 hours for all locations, or is it as fast as 1 day for selected locations? What do you think the answer is? Do you know the answer? Okay, let's see if everybody knows it as well, okay? Last second, let's see. As fast as 2 hours for selected locations. Well done, most of you got it right. Okay, let's take a look at the leaderboard now. Coming in first, we have Mei Pang, and then Zenali and Dada. Okay, woo, Mei caught up from, I think, fourth or fifth place just now, right? Okay, let's go to our next question. This is question 4 out of 6. Does FairPrice have a freshness guarantee? Is it no, there's no freshness guarantee? Or is it 2, yes, refund guaranteed for unsatisfactory products? Is it number 3, no freshness guarantee, but users can reach out to customer service? Or yes, the spot products will be replaced? Please give me your answers. Let's see, time's up. Most of you said yes, refund guarantee for unsatisfactory products. Well done, that's the correct answer. And let's take a look at a leaderboard for now. Is Mei still in the lead? Yes, oh my god, Mei, you are so fast and accurate. Zena, well done, you're in second place. And Lin Chow, seeing your name for the first time. But well done, thanks for making it to the top 3. Let's go to the second last question. Which baking courses does NTUC Learning Hub and Creative Culinaire Academy conduct? Is it Cakes and Pastries 101? Is it Make Western Pastries? Is it Bread Baking Basic, or all of the above? Chef, you know the answer for this one, right? Definitely. Do you want to give us a clue? Oh, plus many more. Okay, let's see. The correct answer is all of the above, which most of you got it correct. Well done, everybody. Okay, let's see the leaderboard again. Is Mei still in the lead? Oh, wow. Mei and Zena still in second place, securing it strong. And Nicole, welcome Nicole to top 3. Okay, guys, we're going to go into our last question. Okay, this is your last chance. Let's go. LHub or FairPrice question. Oh, okay. Who will pick out the freshest products in your order? Is it machinery, regular staff, trained staff, or option number 4, machinery as well? Okay, this is your last 8 seconds and your final chance to catch up. Let's see if Mei Pang is still in the lead, you know?
Yeah.
Okay. Well done, once again, most of you got it correct. It's trained staff who are able to pick out quality fresh products. Okay, this is the final leaderboard, guys. Let's take a look at the top 3. Okay, in third place, we have Jenny Wong. Wow, Jenny got 6 out of 6 correct. In second place, Zena Lee. And in first place, is it Mei Pang? Is it Mei? Let's see. It is Mei! Well done! Alrighty, for the 3 of you, please take a screenshot of your winning screen. Okay, I'm going to pause here for a little while for you to take a screenshot. And also PM us your details. Alright, and FairPrice will be contacting you on the redemption of the e-vouchers. Alright, so for everyone else, don't worry, because there's a special promo code for all of you. It's Baking Fresh. Okay, from FairPrice, you get $5 off, valid with a minimum of $35 spent on fresh produce. Okay, so once again, congratulations to Mei, Zena, and also Jenny. Please remember to take a screenshot and send us a private message with your details, your name, mobile number, and email address so that we can get in touch with you. Okay, so welcome back, everybody. Chef, how are we doing on the Kueh Lapis?
Yes, actually, while we were having the quiz, the first layer was actually cooked after about 6 minutes. But it's also very important that when we spread the second layer, okay, I sort of put it back into the oven because so that everyone has it should be warm or hot straight from the oven before we put in the next layer, okay, of the batter, which will be the white layer, and we spread it out, okay. Now, spread out until it sort of melts a little bit over the top layer, over the first layer. Because if the first layer is hot, then you can see it will start to melt a little bit. Now, we want that to happen because you want the kueh lapis to have a kueh lapis texture, which is slightly flexible and pliable. If you just simply place the each layer over it, and just go continue to bake it, it will just taste more like a normal cake. So you see, I actually have to sort of spread it out until you see it turns a little bit oily and shiny. Okay, so use your spoon to just gently touch the first layer. Now, the first layer should be cooked. So how to know whether it's cooked is to just press it. If it doesn't stick to your fingers, it's cooked. Now, the trick is not to overcook each layer or to undercook. So powers of observation must be there, okay? if you overcook, you just end up getting a very dry kind of lapis. All right,
oh,
so once you
see,
it's shiny, you can see it shines. Okay, so you sort of, you know, just knock it, and then you continue with the third, the fourth, and the fifth, all the way to the 30 layers, and for the rest of our lives. Okay, now, this will take again maybe 6 to 8 minutes, and we touch it once it's cooked, take it out immediately, spread the third layer, spread it until it sort of melts, and then continue. Okay?
So we're going to repeat, we should repeat the same steps.
Yes,
right?
We repeat the same step. So while we are waiting for the second layer,
we have the magic Kueh Lapis.
Like magic, the Kueh Lapis has been baked. Okay? So, yeah. Now you can leave the cake to cool. You see the first layer comes out, okay, beautifully. And what you do is you can just, if you overturn like this, it doesn't drop off easily. Just get a small, get a paring knife, release the sides like this. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, and then we overturn our lapis.
Okay. Oh, I can't wait to see the beautiful colors inside.
Yes. Okay. All right.
Are you ready for the review?
Yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay, normally you would have to trim the sides first to reveal the layers, okay? So you see, this is the bottom layer. I'm going to flip it back in a short while. So you can just turn it like this. And the layers at the side, you can't really see now, but you just trim it, okay?
Actually, Chef, I'm
and
quite curious.
You can see, yes.
What
yes.
is the approximate weight per layer?
Well, it's about maybe about 180 grams per layer, plus and minus, okay?
180
so,
grams.
Yeah, you can use your use the ladle as a guide, okay? So now.
Oh, it's beautiful. You know, it kind of reminds me of, it's giving me very 90s vibe, because I'm a 90s baby, right? And I remember, like, I used to see all these bright, beautiful colors.
Okay.
And it's giving me a very nostalgic feeling.
Okay,
beautiful.
Fiona,
yes.
I have to admit, I probably said the wrong thing. Cannot be 180 grams per layer because I was thinking of the huge trays that we use.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
if 430 grams per portion and we divide into like 20, 30 this, it's probably less than 100.
Okay, okay.
Okay? Oh. All right, but use the ladle as a guide. I think that would be great. Okay, now you can see the sides like this. Okay, all the layers. And then if I were to slice them, okay? So again, you reveal more layers.
Oh,
so you can cut,
beautiful.
You know, four pieces, one for mother, one for mother-in-law, you know, first son, second son, third son. Okay? Like this. All right? And we have got more that's been already sliced and ready to serve.
Oh, look at that.
Okay? All right? So, and the best part is if you look at the layers, why it's actually a very nice and moist lapis is that it's actually quite pliable. You see it like this?
Yeah.
It's actually pliable. Now that is, to get this texture, it's important that every layer when you spread, it should actually melt, okay, on the hot layer. This is very important. Okay?
So we should see like a shiny glaze, like you said just now,
yes.
right?
Okay,
okay, it's time to check the oven
I can
already.
Show the third layer.
Okay, in the,
like
in the meantime, I just want to do a quick reminder to our Kahoot quiz winners, Jenny Wong, Zana Lee, and Mei Pang. Please remember to provide us with your name, mobile number, email address, and also the screenshot of the Kahoot quiz, okay? So how's it doing, Chef?
Okay, almost ready. Now, just to show you, now, when it's already done, if you were to touch it, you see, it doesn't stick to my fingers, okay? Like this, it's cooked because every layer is very thin layer, so it will cook quite quickly. And the fact that we use a water bath to cook this Kueh Lapis ensures that it's not dry and it's still moist, okay? That's quite important. So we actually place a layer of water in the tray All right, hot water, then we bake layer by layer, all the way till the last layer.
Okay? I actually can't wait to taste the kueh lapis. I'm actually kind of getting hungry because I can smell it. It smells so good.
Yeah, thank you.
And also a special promo code for everybody. Thank you all for tuning in. You know, our special promo code is Baking Fresh. So once again, we're going to put it up on the screen. So if you use Baking Fresh for FairPrice app, you will get $5 off. It's valid with a minimum of $35 spent on fresh produce. And this is limited to the first 300 redemptions only, okay? So we have, Linda is asking, do we use water bath for normal egg yolk lapis?
It depends on your oven, right? Depends on your oven. Mm. Certain ovens, certain brands of ovens have been very famous for the ability to bake the kueh lapis without the water bath.
Oh, wow.
So they have a special grill function. But in some ovens, like certain built-in ovens, they are, if you were to bake layer by layer, it seems to take a long time and it ends up as a very dry lapis. That is why we use the water bath for this particular, for most of the ovens when we are baking. Even in our huge deck oven, when we bake in for our bakery, we actually use the water bath in the deck oven so to ensure moistness in every layer. Okay, so you can see now it looks shiny. Ooh. Let me try to catch the shine in the light. Okay, so this only happens if you put the next layer while it's still hot and take a little bit of time to use like the spoon or something to just spread it out so that it's in contact with the heat and you don't get, so that you get that shiny layer. And this is how you achieve your rather pliable kind of texture for your lapis.
And that is about 20 layers over there, right?
Sometimes it's like saying, oh, I have 1,000 children, you know. We take it metaphorically, okay? just enjoy every layer, 20, 30, 10. Also depends if you wish to make more, like sometimes, you know, for a bakery, we make a lot more and then we can go up to 20 layers and we spread it on the big 60 by 40 kind of tray in the deck commercial oven. Now, that's what we share with our students because one day you never know, you may have to bake it in a big oven, whether you're working in a bakery or starting your own bakery. Yeah. Then you will see that how to scale up is what some of the tips that we share during our WSQ courses with NTUC Learning Hub at Creative Culinaire Academy. So we really hope to welcome all our students and share with you the joy of baking, whether it's baking for your family or for your business. We will be very happy to share the secrets of baking, as is actually the motto of our academy.
Yes. Oh, thank you so much, Chef. That was so generous of you. But also, I want to ask, you know, can we try the kueh lapis?
Of course! Of course! Now,
I have been waiting for this moment.
All right, okay. Come, you can try.
Maybe
this.
We can have Lam to start first, because you are today.
You can today. Also try.
You are chef's helper today.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Now, we bake this, my guys bake this in the deck oven, in our commercial big deck oven. This is baked in this oven, okay? Also with water bath, okay? But there is still the same, okay? Just to show you that what we do for the business, all right? Okay.
Please go for it. When
come, please, please. Okay. Have more, yeah.
Oh, it's very moist.
Yes. Yeah. Okay? Come, Lam.
Okay, thank you.
Great.
You can really taste the coconut, huh? Yeah.
Yes, the pandan. And the actually, the main thing is the salt. Because the salt does also bring out the flavor of the coconut. Anything with coconut, a touch of salt. I still remember my late grandma, you know, when she made those ondeh-ondeh, you know, the white coconut, when you coat it, you got to put some salt in it, and it seems to bring out the taste. So, yes.
I have no idea.
And you can try as well. This is also baked in the this oven.
So this is the fresh one.
Yes. No, both are fresh, just that in different ways of, you know. Okay.
It's so good.
Mm, yeah.
Yes, I really hope, you know, you can make this for your family. You know, very importantly is to weigh your ingredients carefully, how to whisk your egg white, you know, and preheat your oven. Always preheat the oven. You know, in our WSQ course notes, my team and I always emphasize preheat your oven. Procedures in baking. Sometimes it's not just a recipe. The secret is the process. what you must do first, what, you know, like little tips, like for example, you spread, like I mentioned, if it was not shiny, you will not get this texture. It's a little bit different, okay?
It is really, really very smooth. And thank you so much, Chef, for sharing the recipe with us and also teaching us how to make this wonderful, tasty egg white kueh lapis. Okay, so just a quick reminder before we end today's live stream. We have one of our winners, Mei Pang. In fact, our first prize winner. Okay, Mei Pang, we're looking for you. Please send in your name, mobile number, and email address, and also a screenshot of the Kahoot quiz. Oh, before we go, one final question. How long can the lapis be kept? Is it at room temperature or do we need to fridge it?
Okay, now the thing is, for commercial lapis, sometimes when they want to keep it for a long time, they do put a little bit of preservative. But in this case, even in the cakes that we sell, we don't put any preservative. But from experience, this cake keeps quite well refrigerated. So what you do is that once it cools down, cling wrap, okay, and then place it in the fridge. And when you want to eat it, thaw a little bit before serving. Then it can keep up to 1.5 weeks. Mm. But do try to also keep it fresh, you know, serve fresh. That is what, you know, we'll
recommend, right?
Certainly taste much better without any chemical or anything.
And I don't, realize, I don't think it will last more than a week because I will finish this in 3 days maximum. One last question. Okay, this is the final last question. Do we need to add water during the baking? The baking.
Yes, that's a very, very good question. Now, as you are baking, if the water happens to evaporate, then top up with more hot water. Now, if hot water is not possible, you use cold water, then it will just take a while to warm up, and that layer may take a longer time to bake. Okay, so yes, as soon as the water starts to drop, the water level starts to drop, then we top up with water. Now, what I did was, you see, this is the tray. You see this black tray? Usually will come with any oven that you buy. So what we do is that we pour water until almost right to the top of the tray before putting the tin into it to bake. It's almost like the way we do a cheesecake. I think it's Cakes and Pastries 101, Lesson 2, where the students bake the cheesecake. So we share with them how to get a very smooth layer by baking in a water bath known as bain-marie. But who is to know, an Asian cake like this, kueh lapis, we also bake in a bain-marie, okay, for most of the ovens to maintain the moist texture.
Yeah. Oh, thank you so much for sharing with us so many tips and tricks. It's definitely very useful. I'm going to go back and try to bake.
Yes,
hopefully
please,
this time
please.
Around it will be a success. Yeah. And also I want to say a big thank you to our two aspiring bakers, Wingy and also Lam, for being here with us. And also, Selamat Hari Raya in advance to Lam. Yes. And also to our Muslim friends who are tuning in. And thank you everybody for waking up so early on a Sunday morning and spending it with us online here at Zoom. So before we end the show, please help us to do a survey. We're going to put up the link in the chat box, and if you cannot do it now, no worries, we'll also send an email over to you. And lastly, don't forget to reach out to our friendly cost consultants like Wingy and Lam. You know, if you want to find out more about such amazing courses like this, we also pin their contacts in the chat for you as well. So thank you so much, everybody. Well done. It was lovely. It was a lovely Sunday morning. Take care, guys. I can't wait to see you again online. Bye bye.
Thank you. See you.